A cone of base diameter 60 mm and axis of 75 mm is resting on its base on the HP. Draw the development of lateral surface when it is cut by an AAP. AAP means auxiliary inclined plane. So those are the planes which inclines with HP. Inclined at 60 degrees to the HP and bisecting the axis. So again here also a solid with a section asking develop surface, but what the object has been given is a cone. The first phase is the solid with sectional plane. You have to draw the solution. So then with considering a sectional plane, develop the respective lateral surface area. So let me draw the solution. Previously we just discussed the cone alone itself without any sectioning. So by the sectioning, how it is affected and how it to be transferred. So let me check from this problem. So before moving the problem, try to remember so data required and you have to use for our drawings. The first thing is a solid cone of base diameter 60 mm and height of 75 mm. Next resting condition, it is rest with its base in HP, clearly given. After that, sectional plane detail, it is making 60 degrees with HP. That means given as a AAP mean, AAP is an inclination plane with HP. From where it is passing, bisecting the axis, develop the lateral surface of the cone. So now we will solve the problem. So now first draw the XY reference line. Just draw a XY reference line. After XY reference line is given, the since cone resting in HP, top view to be drawn as a circle in the top view place. So for that one, take the compass, the since 30 mm radius, that is the diameter has been given as 60 mm. So take the radius of 30 mm and draw the primary top view. So draw the top view first. Since it has been not visible that much, so I will just make it as an ink. Now, which is the top view itself is a represents as a circle of diameter 60 mm. So why we have to draw the top view? From the beginning, so many problems we discussed, you have to observe the resting condition. Since it is rests with its base in HP, our top view to be drawn first. So next, so what the other thing? If it is without any other extension, you need not to be divided. Okay, already one of the problem we did. So without any divisions, because there the only develop the cone has been asked here. The since we are going for the further operation, that is we are section. The since you are making the section, the respective points of a carry on our developed surface. So for that one, you must divide into the any number of equal parts. So either 8 or 12. So always preferably try to do as your chart were 12. But for easy to represent and just making for the feasibility of the in explaining, I am here dividing into the 8 equal. You want to divide into the 12 equal parts, you have to draw the radial line 30 degrees with each. But when you want to divide into the 8, 360 by 8, I am getting the 45 degrees line. So for that one, the less primary, I will draw the primary line is a horizontal line and draw a vertical line which divides segments into the four parts. So now after that, I want to insert the further division. The since I need 45 degrees line, take the protractor and align it properly with the center of the circle. So then identify the angular direction of 45 degrees again 45 degrees. Another side. So once you are identify the angular measurement, so once you are identifying that one, take the normal scale and just along the direction of the angular measurement, connecting with the center and connect them with the radial. This is the division. Similarly, on other side, just take the direction along the angular measurement you did, such that passing through the center in line. So now we are able to represent it. So what are the number of divisions? We divide into the 8 number of divisions. So after that, it has to be labeled every time. Don't forget to label. Let this is the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. And since it is a cone, we are having the only the outer periphery, 8 points only, and apex point here. If it is a cylinder, again exactly the same numbers you are getting as the below side also. So once the top view completed, in shape to draw the respective front view. So for that one, take the rafter. From every reference point, you have to draw the Nice. Okay, since it is a cone, I have to identify the apex also. At the time of the drawing generated itself, I am drawing the axis of reference line so that I can fix the apex point. Next, from other end. So once they are completed, you have to identify the apex. So how much height has been given? Since the axis is a 75 mm long, so measuring 75 mm and marking the respective apex point. Similarly, you can label them in the bottom. This is the A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, here is the E, and behind points are F, G, and H. So now I am connecting just outer periphery lines. The primary I am drawing the very light lines. Primarily, I am drawing light lines. So after that, I can make it dark as per the requirement. So remaining generators. So presently, I am drawing generators with pencil line. So depends on the requirement, I will make it dark here. Now you are able to visible. So I can make these lines. So now we have to add the sectional planes. So what the sectional plane details has been given? So which is bisecting the axis, that is the primary condition. So what the next condition? From where it is passing? It is passing from its midpoint, that is bisecting mid midpoint with an inclination of 60 degrees. So locate the midpoint first. So directly I can identify the sectional point from where it is passing from the axis. So since height is the 75 mm we are taking, I can consider it is 37.5 around. So from here I have to just pass a sectional plane which inclines 60 degrees. To read the measurement of the protractor, I am drawing a horizontal reference line so that I can place the protractor comfortably. Since you have to graduate 60 degrees angle, take the protractor and place it properly where you want to measure the inclination. So just I am placing here. So now since I need 60 degrees, I am marking the inclination of the 60 degrees. So once I have marked the 60 degrees inclination, you have to, in the direction of that one, you have to represent a sectional plane. So let I am drawing the sectional plane. So let I will draw the sectional plane. So for that, you have to take the normal scale help and in the direction of angular measurement and passes through the point required, that is the bisection, that is the midpoint, and I will draw the sectional plane. So after that, add the arrow lines here. So now identify the sectional points, how many points are getting. So for that one, I can take here. It is cutting here, the first primarily, where it is cutting. The base AB, we are having AH also. I am getting the 2 points here. Next, immediately, it is cutting the generators also. After that, it is cutting this generator. Again, it is cutting this generator, again it is cutting this generator. You have to logically identify, so where the seams as a single line, where you are getting the two lines, one is the behind line, so there you have to get the two points each. And start the visible points to be first, visible edges to be priority, then hidden points to be identified later, in the same sequence, how we are moving from one generator to the other generator. So being it is first, it is representing AB as well as AH, I am getting the first point as a P dash. But next visible, it is the, where is the next visible? B. The since I am getting this as the Q point, next here is the R, next here is the S, T, behind is you are having U, behind we are having the V, behind I am having the W, behind I am having the X. So now this is related to the sectional triangle. That means I am making highlight here. So what to be considered for the sectional? So this part you have to consider the sectional. So now same thing you have to show onto the respective top view. So for that one, use the mini drafter and correspondingly transfer every point onto the respective edges. The primary points getting very close here, just before of B, just before of H. So those points are P and X points. Next, coming to the Q and W points. These are the Q and W points. Next, R and V. So for R and V, what the problem we are having? it is again merging along the side. So in such case, what I suggested, it has to be transferred to the nearest any true length. From there, it has to be transferred to the respective length. So then it has to be reflected back. Then it has to be taken back. So temporarily I'm taking R and V, but R and V should be on OC and OG. The, since it is merging, if I draw the line, I am transferring onto the edge of OE. So from OE, I am transferring the corresponding to the top view. So once I am transferring corresponding top view, so now I will measure the distance, and this distance has to be transferred back onto the respective edges. It has to be transferred with the same radius onto the respective edges. So what are the respective edges? Here is the OC and here is the OG. That means this R here and V here you have to get. So when there is the coincidence, you have to do that process. So let me take another points now. S and U on the D and F. So straight away I am transferring those points up to D as well as F. Remaining T is the alone point which is on E. I am transferring the point alone onto the T. So next I will label the respective points. How to label now cross here? Here is the P on the edge of AB. On the edge of the AB, I am getting here, this is the P point. On the other side, I am having the X point. A very close, nearer to the B, not exactly on the B. So after that, we are having the points, the Q and W. Here is the Q and here is the W. After that, R and V. Here is the R, here is the V. Next, S and U. Here is the S. Here is the S, here is the U. Next, T is the alone point, here is the T. You have to connect such that what are the points on the flat, so those should be straight edges. What are the points on the curved surface, those should be connected by the curved line. So for that one, I will take the scale. So the since the P and X are on the flat surface of the AB, the since those points to be connected with the straight. These points to be connected straight. Next, the remaining points has to be connected. How those to be connected? Since those are representing the curved points, so it should be joined by a smooth curve. So this is the respective top view of the section. So now whenever the sectional area affected, the normal tradition, you have to differentiate them by drawing the hatching lines. Hatching lines are nothing but uniformly drawn angular lines. I'm just drawing those angular lines to differentiate them from normal area. All these are mandatory practices. Even it is not asked, so whenever the section, try to do the perfect representation. So now completed sectional part. So then coming to the development of the surface. So now let me consider the without the section, how to develop first consider. So without going for our sectional effect. So normally how to be considered, so whenever there is a cone, so there also you have to apply the radial method. So when you want to radial method, you should know the true slant length. So now we can observe here, so either OA or OE, both are parallel to the XY. The since these are the parallel to XY, indirectly this OE is the parallel to vertical plane. So whenever the parallel to the vertical plane, respective front view edge length is the true length. That means I can consider this length and I can draw that as the primary side. After that, I can extend the any blind length in the previous case of the pyramid. But whereas the cone, we are not having the any base number of bases. So for that one, I cannot conclude where it could be n. So for that one, whenever there is a cone, you have to calculate indirect calculation. So that is the how much angle will be subtended. So for complete its development. So for that one, you have to use a relation. So that relation is nothing but, so theta equals to small r by capital R into 360 degrees. So what is the small r? Radius of the cone. So which peaks that one is nothing but 30 mm. Of that, capital R to be taken. So what the capital R? Capital R is nothing but the length measured along the true slant length. So this is a true slant length. And let I am measuring this one. And how much I am getting? Let us see. The height is different, this one is different. I am getting around 81. I am getting this around the. So when you are getting the 81, yes, I am getting 81 mm. I have to draw that as a 81. multiplied by 360 degrees. How much are getting? Let I calculate. For that one, you can use your calculator. How much? 30 divided by 81. So this one you are getting multiplied by 360 degrees. How much are getting? Around 133 degrees. So after that, how much it could be divided? It is approximately 133 degrees. The sector angle to be divided such that, being it you have divided the 8 radial points, so there also you have to divide that sector also into the 8. So divided by 8, so around I am getting 16.7 degrees each. Every point you have to take. For 16.6 degrees, are you measured with our protractor? This is limitation up to the only the 1 degree. In between I cannot make, so let I make it the nearest value. So what the nearest value 16.7 mean? I can make into 16.7 mean nearest is 17 degrees. So just like that indirect calculation I took. If it is of 17 degrees, you want to make into the 8 parts. So how much it could be? 17 into 8. You can calculate back here. 17 into 8. So you are getting 136 degrees. So that I can approximate this angle into 136 degrees. So that's only the approximation method. So for feasibility in the next stage divisions, you have to calculate accordingly. But on the calculation part, you can show the same calculation as part, but the construction is a little difficult. So because I can measure up to the decimal fraction of the angular measurement with the help of the protractor. So like that, you have to make into the generalized way, you have to make it the rounded. The nearest round value you have to consider, based on that one, you have to use for the construction. So now once I will draw the development of its surface. By considering these values, you have to measure the angle already and measured here, how much slant length, 81 mm slant length I am getting. So by considering, you have to just with the calculation of the subtended angle, you have to draw the sector. So for that one, so draw the primary side. So what the primary side has been known, it is of 81 mm length with any initiation. It is need not to be a compulsory a fixed length. So for that one, I am locating a particular point. The some point I will just identify here. So after that, so instead of the drawing the first primary, I can blindly use the compass to measurement. Why? Because measuring again will be transferred a little time waste. So instead of that one, so just I am directly measuring this one. And this center what you have referred, so from there we have to draw one blind arc. So what are the primary arc to be drawn? A little blind arc. So after that one, you have to take one of the standard reference line first. Let him taking any one of the standard reference line. So let him consider here, this is the standard reference line. From here you have to identify the other extreme. So for that one, I can label this as the A and this as the O. Again, O into P is the last point to be identified with an angle of 136 degrees. So now whenever you want to angular measurement, you have to just take the protractor. Let's take the protractor, align it properly here. Okay, from where you want to make the measurement, align it properly. Just now, identify the angle required 136 degrees. At the same time, while you are making that itself, you can do the another process. What the another process? The since you want to divide into the 8 equal parts, at each radial line you are getting the 17 degrees. So for that one, I can identify the 17 degrees also at this instant. So 17 degrees plus again 17, how much? 34 plus 17, 51 plus 17, 68 plus 17, 85 plus 17, 102 plus 17, 119. Plus 17, 130. Like that. At the same time, whenever want, I can make it complete protractor by simultaneously. So then take the pencil or otherwise, I know that first outer extreme. So what is the outer extreme? So this is a primary sector we are divided of an angle of 136 degrees with approximation. After that, you have to draw the radial line. So primarily, being it is a section, I draw the primary radial lines with the line. After that, by adding the sectional point, I will make it dark as per my consideration. So for that one, just I am drawing the every radial line first, a light line only. Okay, until the periphery you have to extend all the radial line so that we can divide all these things into the same number of circle you have divided. Since you have divided the circle into the 8, you have to divide this sector also into the 8 number of divisions. So once you have divided, you have to label them accordingly. So how those to be labeled? The same points whatever taken on a periphery. So since A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H and the last ones same point as the starting and end point, both will be same. That's why A and repeatedly you will be able to get A. So if you want to divide logically, the first primary 17 degrees at a, because you have to identify the each line with the protractor, small gradation, you feel sometimes difficulty. The primary angle to be precisionally you have to make measurement. The first radial line place very precisionally. So after that 17 degrees to be tar, after that you can like that offset. You are getting everywhere exactly same point. So like that also you can do for your dividing, that is at your convenience by applying your common sense. So whatever the technique you are, it is the correct you are being, then you can apply. Okay. So normal way, the angle divided by number of division at the same time with the protractor can identify. Otherwise, if you feel difficulty to identify the angular measurement with help of the protractor, at least the first angle, so whatever the 17 degrees in this case, just very precisionly identify. After that, take the compass, measure the distance here to here. After that, every point has a reference offset so that you are exactly divided into the number of equal divisions. So now this is the normal developed surface of a cone, but what I need by sectional points to identify. So for that identification, you have to consider here. Now the concept P to be transferred, but where is the P? It is on the effect of AB. So it has to be transferred accordingly as per where it is location on the projection. So on this top view, the P is located between A and B. So that means between A and B, near to the B, I have to locate the P. So for that one, how it can be located? So here there is no other means, you have to measure the distance from B to this one. Okay, measure the distance. Very close distance and measure same accordingly, it has to be transferred. With the compass being it is a very small, I cannot transfer. The only in this case, I have to measure. If I measure from B to P, it is around 1 mm. So that 1 mm has to be now transferred with respect to B on the periphery. Just it is only a small error, maybe you can count here this point to be transferred. So now this is the point of P. Similarly, where the other point we are having? X. On the periphery we are having the X also. Due to the symmetry, how much distance it is there? The same distance you are having. But from the H. From the H towards A. From the H towards A, approximately 1 mm. So this point is the X point. Now come to the remaining points, either Q, R, S, T, U, V, W. So where those points are there? Those are points on the generators. So you have to locate on the generator the respective points. But you have to keep in mind, every time what you are locating on the generator, those must be measured actual lengths. That means the true representation only to be transferred, that since the developed surface, every measurement is true. So on observation, either this B, C, D, F, G, H are not the true, but because all are making some slant, the since those are not representing the true length, every point has to be transferred onto the true length. So which is the true length you can observe here? Along the OE. The since OE is parallel, the respective O dash, E dash only the true length. So you have to transfer every measurement onto that one. So then you have to transfer back onto the developed surface with respective distances. So further transferring, we can use the mini doctor. So once you want to use the mini doctor, I can check here x y reference line coefficients. Because this precision, every time you have to check back, otherwise sometimes you may get error measurements. So every point that the t is already located, I am transferring left s1, next already the located, next this w part q you have to transfer. So next are the points you have to. So now this is the location of the T. So let identify every point of reference first. This is the T, this is the S and U, this is the distance of R and V. So this is the distance of Q and W. Then already T and I. P and X are located on the base. So now with the help of the compass, every point to be transferred onto the respective generators. So for that I take the next is the Q point. I am taking the distance here along the true length and I am transferring corresponding. But where is the Q should be? So on the BH I am drawing an arc. Similarly, same distance W we are having, but W is on the behind H. So where the H we are having? Here is the H. The same distance I can transfer at the same time. So that means, so this point is the Q point. So next, this point is the, what the other point? W. Next, similarly, other set of the points, I can measure along the two dimension. So that is the R and V at the same location. But where to be located those one? On this one, R you can observe. So where is R we are having? On the edge of C. So on the edge of the C, transfer here. At the same distance, we are having one more point, which is on G. So transfer onto the G. So now label the points here. So this point is R and this point as, what the other point? V point. This is the V point. Similarly, you can transfer S and U. Measure the S and U. This to be transferred onto the respective OD and OF. Okay. These points representing here S and this point is representing U. So, what the alone point is left over is the T. So, that is directly on the E. So, just I am measuring here and transferring onto the EH. Onto the HE. So, now this is the point of T. Now, every point has to be connected. On connecting, you have to take care to consider the surface condition. If it is on the flat surface, point to point is the edge. Whenever the curved surface, point to point is the smooth curve. So, by taking that one, the PQ, RSTU, everything is on the curved surface. So, you have to start from here. Every point has to be connected such that a smooth curve to be connected. This one is the required solution. So next, this part also I am making highlighting. So whatever just making in red ink you are showing here. So that is the developed surface of the given object. That is a cone. This part has been removed from the actual cone here. So like that one, you have to draw the solution. So let I can consider the problem and how it meeting our solution. So what the problem has been given? A cone of base diameter 60 mm, axis of 70 mm, rests with its base in HP. It is cut by a sectional plane which inclines 60 degrees with horizontal plane and bisecting the axis. Develop the lateral surface of area. So this is the condition of the solution. This is the develop. Every part while shifting, what the care to be taken? Every measurement measured on the developed surface must be a true length. So that only you have to caution. So next, add the dimension part so that I can complete the solution. Just add the arrowheads here. Since it is of 75 mm, 37.5 mm. What the diameter has been given? It is of 60. So like that, we can complete by adding the solution. So in this one, whenever the cone, being we are not having the definitely measurement of the end surface, you have to just add the calculation part to calculate the theta. So once you are getting the theta, measure the slant length from here. The slant length has to be shown here. The slant length you have to consider also must be shown. How much I am getting? Here is the 81 mm. So like this, then we are able to complete the solution for the what the problem has been asked.